The Second Itakwade Metropolitan Assembly says it is working towards deepening its open governance structure, where local governance discussion will be brought to the doorstep of people here in the metropolis. And so today I'm at a SIPON to find out what they make of this particular proposal of open governance. This is News Connect on City TV, and I am Akwesi Ejeni. As a resident of Esipon, which is also located in the Second Itakwade Metropolitan Assembly, do you feel the STMA is that open and why?
Okay. No, the STMA is not open for us because sometimes we go and report something to the STMA. They do nothing about it. So I think it's not open for us.
What about you?
I'm also saying it's not open. My reason is they should be consulting us in any developmental project they are having in a community. But if you don't know anything about it, and then in a while you see some project going on, sometimes it's not what the community wishes for. But because of lack of consultation, it will be there, and the project wouldn't be in need. They wouldn't be using it in the community. But if there should be a proper consultation for that one, if the people has a need for such an item, then we shall benefit from it.
No, because as my brother said, they are doing contract in this town. We are not aware of it. Even we don't know even the contractor that is doing the work. So far as we are in this community, we have to be aware of this contract. We will meet the contractor. Even sometimes we have to monitor the work. But we don't do anything about it. Just we'll be there and we see they are working us. We are not aware of it.
When you complain, when you make such complaints to the STMA, do you get feedback? Do they come back to you to tell you why they are doing that or why they are not responding to some of the things that you request for?
No, they don't respond. Or they don't give out the feedback. We don't get anything from the STMA. When we report, we don't get any information back to us.
For you, I mean, when it comes to response from the STMA?
In response, I would say they are just riding over us. But we are thanking God for this opening governance, if only it is going to be continued. As from time to time, our views shall also be respected, and then we address them to the necessary agencies under STMA.
Madam, when it comes to response, I mean, are you that satisfied with why they behave the way they behave?
I don't think so. Because STMA have a toll-free line. You call, you report something to them, they will not get back to you. Several times. The last time I went to town hall meeting, I reported, but the PM was even agree with me that what I'm saying is not true. But it's true.
I mean, how does all these things affect the development of Esipon, the community that you live in?
It's affecting us really, very badly. Because let me say, we have a youth in this community. Even if the oldest people doesn't know anything about it, the youth supposed to know to find out as they are doing the open governance. I think anything that STMA will make at them, they have to be open so that as the youth in this town or in this community will be aware of it so that we can follow it.
It has hurt us a lot because when you give us a complaint to somebody and all of a sudden you refuse your complaints, it means you are doing nothing, a 0% work. So we want the STMA, when they are coming to doing something here, we must know the accountability of the project so that we, the youth, we can help the STMA to do it with our strength or without anything that we can have in our community.
What are some of the problems that you think the STMA should be looking at that you are not getting a response for?
I think STMA is supposed to come to the community for some services. They shouldn't wait that we should come to their office for complaint or something. For that one, it's wrong.
Services like what?
Town hall meeting, as we are getting today, STMA is supposed to get in that program so that they will know something that's going on, what is right and what is not right. So I think STMA is supposed to gather town hall meeting even at least twice in a year or once in a year. I think that one also will help.
Any other things that you think the STMA should be looking at for you to feel that they are actually a listening, assembly?
Yeah. We have a lot on our preference, but the immediate ones we need is the drainages. The community is familiar with some two things in common, that every year there will be a flood in the community and people's items, gadgets will be destroying. I always have to be chasing NADMO and stuff. If they want, they will come and look at it. If they don't like it, I'll report it several times for no response. And then also the quarry, as we said, it has really been a headache for us. Dust and then crackings. You know, when they blast boulders, the stones, they split. They explode. And whenever they explode, some force in the community, if you are not lucky, it might meet somebody and that will cause another problem. Because, as I said earlier, the leaders, nobody cares. They are not coming to look at our cry, why we are reporting constantly. So now everybody has relaxed because it has become something common for us.
For you, I mean, what are the final things you want to say in terms of what will make the STMA look more transparent and more open?
Accountability. When you go to market, does STMA workers, they collect money? What are they using that money for? I think they should use that money for a project. It's not anything that we look for the government. No, as they are, STMA in our second Itakwade metropolitan, they have to help in terms of that a little money that they are collecting from us. Even those having a shop a year, as I'm saying, I have a shop a year, I pay about 150 Ghana cedis. What are they using that money for? So I think STMA have to do accountability for the community so that they will know the money that they are collecting. That's the benefit coming out of it.
Lastly, what I'm saying is we need open governance as it has started now. And it's a sign of positive something going on. We need to be, feeling the government, whatever the government is doing, if you also have a say, if you have any contribution, as it has happened now. We wish this will happen, as my sister said, but twice a year, we will be happy so that we know what is going on, our views will be accepted. Then if not accepting our views, we know that this is what the government is doing, So it's a good sign of improvement.
Thank you. You have been accused of having a toll-free line people call, but they don't get responses. Their concerns are not addressed. Is this something that you hope to capture it under this open governance project to make sure that people also get a feedback on what they call to complain?
Yes, it's one of the things we are looking at in the open government project that we are doing, because we have also as an assembly also hear the people's concern that the mechanism that we put in place in order to get feedback from the citizens is not working, and it is really an issue that we have discussed it at the management level. And this project has come at the right time, and we are looking at how we can, reactivate that toll-free line and even bring on board other technologies that we can use to enhance our service delivery.
Are you confident and hopeful about the new, partnership project the STMA is trying to introduce, the open governance project? Do you think that is the way to go? That is what is going to actually open your community to development?
Yes, I think so, because from day one, it is not there. Today, we have come to understand that there are so many things that was not opened. But today, as this partnership issue has come, this one is going to help us. And as a member of the committee, I will really assure my people that with me in the forum, every community will be assured that the openness has to come.
For residents of Esipon, such locally based community interaction is what will make them feel that the STMA is actually practicing open governance. This has been News Connect from Esipon, and I am Akwesi Ejeni.